Hello everyone, welcome to Blue Cube channel. In the continuation of the After Effects tutorials, in this video, you will learn how to use the color balance HLS and color link effects. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you do. I select the layer and open color correction from the effects panel, and then apply color balance HLS effect on the layer. The color balance HLS effect changes the color, brightness, and saturation values. This effect is only for compatibility with projects created in previous versions of After Effects that use the color balance HLS effect. We use the hue saturation effect for new projects, which we will cover in the next videos. Using lightness, I increase the brightness. I also increase the value of saturation, which causes the concentration of colors in the image. By activating and deactivating the effect, you can see the color and light change. Finally, by changing the hue value, we can change the colors of the image in this way. There is nothing special about this effect, so I delete this effect and go to the next composition to check the color link effect. In this composition, I have already inserted a video to add the color link effect to it. This effect paints the color of one layer with the average pixel value of another layer. And it's useful for quickly finding a color that matches the color of the background layer. So first I type a text and place it in the middle of the image. Now I add the color link effect to the text layer. As you can see, since the text color is white, after adding the effect to the text layer, the image will become white. By pressing the Stencil Original Alpha button, we can see the text. Using the Source Layer option, select the layer from which we want the colors to be sampled. Here I choose Layer 2. In this way, the color of the text during the video samples the colors of the Layer 2 image. As a result, the color of text and image is similar. Now I change the sampling values using the sample options. As you can see, the average option is selected by default. I choose brightest as a result, the color of the text became lighter. I also tried darkest and other options. By selecting each option, changes are made in the light and color of the text. At the bottom are the alpha options, and because my background layer has no alpha, it won't change. But I'll make some alpha in the background very quickly so we can see the result. I double-click on the composition and now search for the color key effect. After adding the effect to the layer, I choose white color for the color key. And I take the video a little further. I increase the value of color tolerance, now you can see that we lose parts of the image. If the grid transparency button is not active, activate it. I also slightly increase the values of the edges. This way I created some alpha for the background. Now I go back to the previous composition and create a solid. I put the solid layer as the lowest layer and select the text layer again. Selecting Mini Alpha will hide the text. And by selecting the Average Alpha option, we can see the background under the text. Note that the alpha value is different in different frames, as a result, we cannot see the background behind the text in some frames. I choose the brightest again. The Clip option indicates the percentage of pixels that are ignored by extreme channel values. Clip value is 5% by default. Increasing the clip value will result in slower color changes for the text during the video. And if you set its value to 0, the text color changes during the video faster. Opacity shows the amount of blending of this effect with the original image. The lower you make this value, the less it affects the layer. By using the blending mode menu and selecting any option, you can create a different blending mode. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.